Welcome you all with my love and respects. I welcome all the Sarvanipet Yajamans, devotees, disciples, satsangis, samajis, srimahans, mahans, everyone sitting with us all over the world, and Nityananda Yoga Teachers Training participants, Nitya Kriya Yoga participants who are here to receive Vishesha Diksha today. I welcome all of you with my love and respects. I'll expand on physics, chemistry and biology of master-disciple relationship. Of course, I don't think I can complete explaining the whole physics, chemistry and biology in one day. I'll start today. Maybe it'll have to happen like a series. Fundamentally, Hinduism is Guru Sishya Sampradaya. That's all. We are not organized religion, we are organic religion. Understand? Organized religion means there's an organization, ultimate superior structure, then various levels, and all the sub-organizations and indirect direct branches of the organizations come under them. We are organic religion. Anywhere an enlightenment is grown, you will see Sangha happening around. Anywhere enlightenment grows, Sangha happens. And the beauty is each Sangha is independently connected to the ultimate truth in their own capacity. There is no organization claiming the supremacy over all the Sanghas. Understand? Even in Akada, there is no such thing as Mandaleshwars or Mahamandaleshwars or under Acharya Mahamandaleshwar. No. No. It's a democratic structure of Mandaleshwars. That's all. All Mahamandaleshwars. And you need to know for quite a long time, Niranjani Nirvani had Acharyas getting rotated every 12 years. Every 12 years, after one Mahakumbh Mela, there will be new Acharya. Even now, Niranjani was following, just as recent as last Kumbh Mela, Niranjani was following. The Acharya coordinates all the Mandaleshwars and Mahamandaleshwars. That's all. Acharya is not declaring his supremacy over other organizations. You don't need to bow down to Acharya. And I have not bowed down to both the Acharyas. I am very clear. I have not touched their feet. Neither the earlier Acharya nor I have not touched any Acharya's feet. Neither Niranjani nor Nirvani nor Juna. I bow down out of respect. Never I was expected to touch their feet, nor they demanded or they expected. Neither I did nor they expected. Out of my own respect, if I bow down or touch some Swami's feet, that's up to me, but no guru expects. Understand? I wanted to put this on record because you need to know we are not organizational religion. We are organic religion. That's the beauty of Hinduism. Hinduism is nothing but Guru Shishya Parampara. That's all. Nothing but Guru Shishya Parampara. That's all. Kashi is just a settlement happened around Mahadeva. That's all. Guru Shishya Parampara. Over. Thiruvannamalai is a settlement around Arunagiriyeshwara. That's all. Last few days I am studying the Kamikagama and Thiruvannamalai, Google Earth. Thanks to Google Earth, really helping us to map. I am actually mapping the Kamikagama into Thiruvannamalai. Such perfect Shiva city. See, here, banyan tree is Sadashiva, is Mahasadashiva. The linga represents the Mahasadashiva, accepts puja. But banyan tree is Mahasadashiva. Same way in Thiruvannamalai, Arunachala, that hill is Mahasadashiva. Because you can't pour the water and do all the abhishekam, alankaram and enjoy, celebrate the kriya. The linga represents Mahasadashiva, receives puja. So the whole temple is centered on linga, city is centered on hill. For example, west, the Koshtamurti of Lingodbhava should be installed in every Shiva temple. And south, Dakshinamurti should be installed as a Koshtamurti. North, Durga and Brahma should be installed as a Koshtamurti. If you see Thiruvannamalai Google Earth, everything is perfect. The number of tanks should be installed as per Kamikagama. The deities need to be installed. You see the south exactly, there is a beautiful huge Dakshinamurti temple in Thiruvannamalai. The Dakshinamurti Koshta Murti size and the hill size, if you match, it is matching exactly the proportion as per Kamikagama. And Lingodbhava Murti is the Adi Arunachaleshwara. Everything on the north, Durga temple is there. That is what is Pavadakundru. Just near Pavadakundru, there is a Durga Devi temple, which is a Koshtamurti. For if you consider hill as a linga, the Koshtamurti in the north is Durga temple is there. I was actually shocked to see, and thanks to Google Earth, last few days I am sitting with Google Earth and Kamikagama. I am sitting with the Google Earth, mapping everything. You need to understand Arunachala. See, in Kailasa, Mahadeva resides on the top. But in Arunachala, hill is Mahadeva. Hill is not his residence, his body. Understand? Whole Hinduism is Guru Shishya Parampara. I'll explain physics of master-disciple connection. Understand. If you want to become a doctor, practicing doctor, you have to be in hospital. No other way. If you want to become a practicing lawyer, not that the lawyer who tries to get the jamin from ocean. If you want to, if you are really interested in practicing lawyer, you have to go to court every day. Where you sleep does not matter. During your waking hours, you have to be in court. If you want to be a doctor, where you sleep does not matter. But when you are awake, you have to be in hospital. Understand, each purpose needs specific vatavarana, ambience where R&D is mastered, research and development is mastered. I am telling you, go to any PhD in any big top 100 university, Harvard, Oxford, any university. Go to any PhD in Oriental philosophies, religion, modern day religious organization, ancient knowledge, wisdom. Talk to any of those doctorates, spend time with them. I challenge, they will be 100 times duller than my Gurukul kids, my Balasans. Understand, internally I will train my Balasans is different. Internally I will work on them to become more and more complete, but externally, for the outer world, they are much more than perfect. Much, much more than perfect. Understand? Vatavarana, ambience. Is required for any excellence. If you want to become a doctor, you have to go to medical college and hospital. If you want to become a lawyer, you have to go to law college and court. Understand, anything you want to do, you have to go to that ambience. You have to master, expertise that ambience. You have to grow in that ambience. All of you need to understand, Adi Kailasa is created not for comfortable life to compare and see how your life is outside and inside. It is created for right, not for pleasant. Yes, naturally alcohol will be more tasty than neem juice. Oh, that is so beautiful after taking this neem juice, huh? Then get lost and bring that. Who says no? Adi Kailasa exists for right, not for pleasant. This very comparison is stupidity. Absolute stupidity.
life in the Adi Kailasa is not for the people who are expecting pleasant, but for the people who are expecting right. And of course, it will be the most pleasant without giving priority to pleasantness. This place and this ambience is created for the people who want to do right thing in their life, not for the people who want to do pleasant things in their life. I have not put a board bar dance club. I have put a board very clearly Adi Kailasa Bengaluru Adina. Let's check the board once more. It is Nityananda Peetham, Bengaluru Adhinam, Adi Kailasam. It is very clear I am running Kailasa. Understand. It is for right, not for pleasant. Physics of master-disciple relationship is living with him. That's all. All other answers are compromised answers. It is straight living with him. Over. Understand that living with him, that word makes world different. Means what are you going to eat? Amazing, best organic food. From there it starts. How living with him prepares you. Listen, food is the first idea, concept with which exploitation on you starts. It is through food society enslaves you. Now literally all the major cities are food deserts, means nothing to eat is available. Understand, they all have food like products, not food. Food like products, not food. When I grew up, I have never seen non-veg being sold so openly in whole Thiruvannamalai. One non-veg hotel used to be there, and people used to treat that like a red light area. No one will go there. If somebody goes there, very secretly they will go, and there will not be any crowd and all around. Secret parcel, pack it and run away and sit outside somewhere outside the city and eat. Now I am seeing everywhere. I think soon they will sell ganja and marijuana openly. Still, they have not put shop, but I don't think it's going to be long time. Because how long you can get owed by opening only alcohol shops? Now people are tired of alcohol. How much you drink? Nothing is happening. Because nowadays the kids by 10 they start drinking alcohol, and by 15 the alcohol is no more helping the system. System has become immune to alcohol. Now you need next dosage. What will happen? What will happen? Next dosage means ganja, marijuana, heroin, all the other drugs. That's all. How government gave a logic? Oh, if we don't legalize it, lot of illegal arak shops are coming. So let's legalize the alcohol. Same way tomorrow somebody is going to declare, if we don't legalize marijuana, ganja, heroin, so much of illegal black market is going on, let's legalize it. That's all. That's where you are heading. That's where you are going. Understand. The layers of addiction in food, things which completely destroys you, tamasic, like marijuana, heroin, ganja, all the other addictive items. See, ghost means which eats its own body parts. That's the definition Mahadeva gives for ghost. A person who is addicted to these illegal drugs are eating his own parts. Like you are eating your own intestine. You are eating your own liver. That's all. To be in the kick. Eating little every day. That is why you are not understanding. Otherwise it is eating. You are a ghost. Once you start getting addicted to the illegal drugs, tamasic, utter tamasic, then tamorajasic. The tamorajasic is this non-vegetarian. Understand, it is such a big anti-social. All of you need to know, largest carbon footprint release on the planet Earth is neither by automobiles nor by army industry. It is by non-veg dairies. Dairy industry. It is not by atomic weapons. It is not by automobile industries. It is not by anything else. It is by dairies and leather industry. Means non-veg production industry. Understand, when a grain grows directly, you eat that, is organic lifestyle. But you feed that to a life and grow muscles and do not care about that life and cut that into pieces and eat. What logic? Where are we heading? Human beings are allowed to own planet Earth, not possess. Not possess. Mark my words. If we don't shut down animal husbandries, dairy farms, which are functioning for meat, I don't see 2060. I don't see 2060. I'm not talking something 100 years after. If you are below 40, you need to think about your future. 40-ish. When I say below 40, 40-ish. You need to think about your future. If you are already above 90, above 70, then who cares? You yourself may not see 2060. Then what is there? Whether 2060 is there or not, who cares? But if you are 40-ish, below 40-ish, you need to think about your future. You are going to face that disaster. Understand, global warming is true, and it is because of non-veg industry. I am not saying this. Google, go to the internet. There is enough statistics. Go Brahmanebhyah Subhamastu Nityam लोका समस्ता सुखिनो भवन्तु को मीन्स एनिमल्स एंड ब्राह्मण हु डज नॉट ईट एनिमल्स एंड प्रोटेक्ट देम बोथ नीड टू बी हैप्पी एंड ब्लिसफुल ओनली देन फ्यूचर इज गोइंग टू बी देयर फॉर अस Fundamentally, it is food. You are exploited. Understand? It's not joke. Seventy-3% of the carbon footprint release. Animal industries. When I say animal industry, three major industry: animals grown for meat, animals grown for leather, animals grown for other medicinal and cosmetic products. Understand? Animals grown for meat, food purposes. Animals grown for leather. Animals grown for medical and cosmetic purposes. This industry forms 73% of the carbon footprint responsible for global warming. That is what I call rajotamasic. Not worst like alcohol, sorry, not worst like marijuana, ganja, heroin, little better, but collectively kills everyone. Ganja, marijuana, heroin, all that, the person will not see even 20-25. With animal husbandry industry, 2060. Then comes Rajasic. Rajasic is all plastic food. Understand? Tamasic, Rajotamasic, and Rajasic. Rajasic is plastic food. Plastic food means food grown out of altered seeds and grown with pesticides and fertilizers. If you see pesticide spraying, they will cover the whole body. It cannot touch your skin, but it can touch some food which you can eat. Adapavila. Something which should not touch your skin can touch your intestine. Aha, what a logic. And you need to know, all the countries which send fertilizers and pesticides to India, they do not buy our vegetables and products back. They send all the chemicals here. When you grow vegetables, rice, anything out of what they sent, they don't buy back from you. They are sending it to destroy you. Large amount of impotency happening is because of the plastic food. Sexually you are made overactive to destabilize the society, but infertility wise you are made inactive, impotent. Understand, there's a big difference between these two. Libido is increased, shoots up. Potency is destroyed, impotent. It's a unique programming going on. It is from food exploitation starts. You are hooked. Understand? No city in the modern world food is available. Kamikagama says, I have seen, not only Kamikagama saying, I have seen my grandfather. Kamikagama says 10 trees, bamboo stick, sorry, drumstick tree, papaya tree, 10 trees he says, should be around, Mahasadashiva says, should be around your house and the cow. You will never be hungry, you will never need to sleep in hunger. How he says, exactly like that, I have seen houses existing in Indian villages. Means each unit is complete self-sustaining for all the fundamental needs. I have seen my grandfather carrying bags of cotton seed, giving and taking the clothes and coming back. For all basic needs, a small unit becomes self-sustaining. And when the British studied Indian system, that was shocking for them. Every village is self-sufficient unit. That is why we made road only for pilgrimage purpose. Kashi to Rameshwaram, Rameshwaram to Kanyakumari, only for pilgrimage purpose we made road. We did not make road for any transportation of goods because every village is self-sufficient. We don't need food transportation and any other transportation. All other items only needed for luxury was transported. For day-to-day running, you don't need any transportation. For life to exist, food, medicine, emergency services, you don't need transportation. Self-sustaining units. They want to break that. That is why they destroyed our goshalas. They destroyed our agriculture. They destroyed our schools. Food like products, not food. All altered, human intervened and altered seeds, human intervened and chemically pumped and chemically protected. Chemically pumped means fertilizer. Chemically protected pesticide. Altered by human beings, the seeds, DNA altered seeds. A fruit should have a seed. How can there be something called seedless grape? By nature, a fruit should have a seed. How can there be something called seedless pumpkin, seedless grapes? God, eat seedless grape, you will become a seedless man. That's all. Understand? Mahadeva says in Kamikagama, a village should have naturally formed honeycombs. The drainage, hen, duck should drink that water and survive. I was thinking, what is the meaning of all that? If the drainage water drunk by ducks and hen and they survive, means the whole thing is organic. There is no chemical in that, in your cooking, in your day-to-day living. If the natural bees are growing honeycombs, means that air pollution, understand, for a bee to survive, four things are required. The ground cannot be polluted. In polluted ground, if a flower grows, if the bee drinks that honey, it will die in few seconds. First thing, the land has to be pure. Second thing, from that land, the flowers which come up, they have to be pure, means air has to be pure. Third, the water source has to be pure. Only then the honey which comes in that water, in that flower, will be pure. So the bee can drink that honey, flourish, and build honeycomb. Understand, bee does not fly more than 1.5 kilometers in their whole lifetime. They live in 1.5 kilometer region only, maximum 1.5 kilometers. Moving them beyond 1.5 kilometers is a big job. It's almost like they lose their balance if they fly continuously more than 1.5 kilometers. So within 1.5 kilometers only they will settle down. If there is a place, natural honeycomb farming, Sadashiva says that is a blessed ground. Start living there, I reside there. Now I understand why he says what he says. Look around our campus and count how many natural bee combs, honeycombs. And he says, hang mango flower. Understand, not fruit, flower. Mango flower. Before becoming fruit, the mango will give a flower, small flowers. Mango flower, neem flower, rice paddy. Hang all that in your door frame. Sparrows should come and eat them. Only then you can live in that house. Means, sparrows have very sensitive lungs. If the air pollution level in that area is very pure, only then the sparrows will come and live there, survive there. If the sparrows are not living or chirping, that place air pollution is not conducive for human lungs to breathe. Go to all cities. Show me a single sparrow in Chennai or Bangalore inside. Single sparrow. Forget about Delhi. Delhi, even you cannot survive. Now, Delhi, actually, you have to develop a new lung to survive. Tons of articles are coming out in the modern day. The chemtrails, chemical trails are infused to keep human beings dull, sober, sick, under control. Every ingredient needed to build the subtle grooves of power manifestation in you will be revived alive at the feet of the master. That is why, if you want enlightenment and power manifestation, you have to be in the vatavarana of the master's feet. You may be crorepati, but you eat only shit. Understand? No, I'm very straight. You may have 10,000 crore wealth, but in the plate only shit. What is the use then? You want 10,000 crore. and you breathe only poisonous air, then what is the use? You live in a place where the sparrows cannot exist. Adhinam, everywhere honeycomb. From Nairuti, Banyan tree, near the Banyan tree now, especially with the new temple construction, so many. And till Ishanya, that whole diagonal, our thousand bed dam. This whole diagonal, you can see honeycombs. Means the whole area, water level, ground, air, all three are pure. You can see ducks, all of them squirrels, drinking our kitchen wastage water. From our kitchen, the wastage water comes out. Early morning, you can see, they will all be drinking. Cranes, doves, squirrels, all of them drink that water and survive. That shows our whole kitchen is running in the organic level, which can be handled even animals' intestine. I was shocked actually. Mahadeva gives instruction to in agriculture. In the Vasanta time, Vasanta is Chitra month, Chitra Masa. In Chitra month, if the dogs don't mate in the street, go and sprinkle neem oil in your agriculture ground, paddy, he is telling. Spray neem oil in your agriculture land if the dogs in your streets don't mate on Vasanta month. Means something is wrong in your grain. Because they are going to eat only what you left. What in those days there was no separate dog food store. What you eat, the remaining you feed the dogs. That's the way the pet dogs are grown. Or the street dogs also. If you keep the food inside the house, they are called pet dogs. If you keep food outside the house, they are called stray dogs. That's all. This is what I call organic life. Understand. Physics of the master-disciple relationship is very important. And if you are serious about power manifestation and enlightenment, if you feel, then no problem. Then you don't need Mysore Road. If you are really serious, if you cognize, it is very rare you get human body, and it is, if you cognize, it is very rare Sadashiva also assumes human body. If you cognize, it is very rare both happening and matching in right time. And if you cognize, this is not the chance to be missed. I have to manifest powers. And I have to become Sakshi Pramana for Shastra Pramana and Apta Pramana, because Atma Pramana is available. Understand, if there was no Shastra, there was only Shastra Pramana and Apta Pramana, Atma Pramana is not available, and you not being here is not crime. When Atma Pramana is available, and if you are interested in Sakshi Pramana, The only way is be in Kailasa. No, I am your close devotee. I worship you every day. I do Guru Puja. Okay. You do Guru Puja, great, no doubt, but I'm not able to send organic food from here to there for you. I'm not able to package this pure air and send it to your home. What can I do? You are breathing that air. It's a, you can't deny it.